So good afternoon all of you. For today's class in herbal drug technology, so we are going to discuss about sources of herbs. In this topic, selection, identification and authentication of herbal materials is what we are going to discuss. Okay, so in the last class I introduced you to herbal drug technology unit number 1. So here we have seen the definition of herbal medicine, what are the different types of products that we have, what are the different types of herbal drug preparations that we have. Till this we have seen, and in case of sources of herbs also I gave you only an outline of sources of herbs. Okay, so here today we'll see selection, identification and authentication of herbal materials in this lecture session. So before going into the actual discussion, first let us see what is a crude drug, because in case of pharmacognosy and also in Ayurveda, whenever and wherever we are using naturally derived materials, this term always crops up. Okay, crude drug. A crude drug is any naturally occurring unrefined substance derived from organic material like plants, animals, microbes like bacteria, fungi, lichens, or organs extracted from animals or whole organisms. Okay, so any one of them, or inorganic materials like minerals, rocks like kaolin, bentonite, etc. Okay, so these are the sources intended for use in the diagnosis, cure, mitigation, treatment and prevention of a disease. Okay, prevention of a disease. We can use the crude drug for any one of these applications, or use it otherwise to enhance physical or mental well-being in humans or animals. So this is the definition of a crude drug. So it is derived from any living or non-living beings that are existing on earth and is used to modify, upgrade and also repair human biological system. So if you see a few examples here, a crude drug usually contains a pharmacologically active ingredient. Okay, crude drug as such we can use, and it usually does not require any additional processing for use. Like here I gave you some example, like ginseng, Panax ginseng, it's a root. The root is directly used, we make a powder and the powder is available in the market, or the powder is added to nutraceutical formulations. In case of digitalis, dry leaf is directly used, and rhubarb, dry root is used, and leaves and flowering tops of peppermint, Mentha piperita, are used in the herbal drug preparations, or bark of cascara, dried milk juice of opium, and whole dried insects like Spanish fly. So in this way, a crude drug can be obtained directly from plant or animal or an exudate or anything like that, and is directly used in preparation of a medicament. Okay, as I mentioned just now, herbal drug preparations are used for prevention of a disease, to fight against infection like antibiotics, and it temporarily blocks a normal function like local anesthetic, or detoxification of body like antidotes, diagnostic agents like radioisotopes which are inorganic salts, correction of dysfunction of heart like cardiotonics, digoxin, correction of hypertension like rowlfear root, prevention of pregnancy like in case of contraception, and curative like elimination of disease like in case of antibiotics we use this type of application. Okay, so if you observe closely, we have various types of crude drugs are there, and multiple applications are also there. So this is what made scientists to consider crude drugs as one of the important member of healthcare management. In one of the study they have seen like 17.7% of US population, especially the young adults, they were using non-vitamin, non-mineral, herbal products or crude drugs for their health management. So this is the reason why it became herbal drugs and other crude drugs utilization in health management has crossed right now $5 billion in the market. Okay, because they are applicate, they are used in various health conditions and they are derived from completely unknown origins. So this is the reason why we need to scientifically study and evaluate and evolve methodologies for authentication of drugs. Okay, so now let us see some of the sources of drugs that we have and why we need to do the authentication, etc. The drawbacks of using a crude drug are, as you all knew, inconsistency with the dosing and quality control. The reason we, the drawbacks with crude drugs are like dosing and quality, because the material obtained either from one of the living source or inorganic non-living source actually changes its chemistry with environment. There are so many parameters which controls bioactive constituent within a plant material or herbal material. So that is the reason why inconsistency will not be there in bioactivity. Potency of herbs obviously are going to be affected, because the secondary metabolite concentration depends on various conditions like growth conditions, soil type, harvesting area, storage and other factors. And the third one is evaluation. Evaluation is so expensive. In most of the cases, it is really tough to identify a material, especially when it is in a, when it is given as a part of multi herbal or multi drug combination. So this is, these are the drawbacks of crude drugs. Because in case of allopathy, we have drugs which are defined, like paracetamol, aspirin, etc. We have two or three drugs, they are there, they can be easily identified or easily evaluated. But in case of crude drugs, let's say 3-4 herbs, when they are mixed, it will become really complicated to see whether a particular drug is of good quality or not. Okay, further, let us see sources of drugs that we use, because this information is needed, because it helps you understand the complexity of crude drug material, obtaining crude drug material including herbal materials. As far as crude drug sources is concerned, one is the plant materials. So within the plant, we use some cases the entire plant, like in case of ergot, ephedra or datura, we use the entire plant. Even vinca, we use the entire plant. Sometimes we use plant parts only, senna leaf, leaf of digitalis, bark of cinchona, seeds of naxomica, rhizome of ginger. It is like this. So sometimes we use the total plant, sometimes you use only the plant parts. Sometimes we use secretion and exudates from the plant. So closely observe that if entire plant is used, like ergot, ephedra, etc., then there is no problem when you add parts of the plant to the actual material. But when we need only senna leaf, along with leaf, if stems or stalks are added, then it leads to reduced potency, or we are actually pulverizing the material. So that is the reason why we need to be aware of the resource from where we can get the bioactive material. So unless we understand the significance of this, we will not be able to understand the way how we can authenticate the drug. Along with this, we do have animal sources. In pharmacognosy, you might have seen several of the materials that are obtained from animals. Sometimes we use whole animals, like Hirudo medicinalis. Do you know this one? It is leech. or shellac is obtained from a secretion of resinous secretion obtained from insect Lecifera lacca. Okay, Lecifera lacca. Okay, so this is the insect lac bug. From where we can get it? Sometimes we use organs and their products. Like we have certain products like cod liver oil, which is obtained from the cod Gadus morua, or human kidney cells from where urokinase is produced, antitoxic sera, spermaceti or wax found in the head cavities of the sperm whale, like this. Because sometimes we use the whole animal, sometimes we use only the organ and the products obtained from the organ. And sometimes we use glandular secretions. Glandular secretions, like honey is also a glandular secretion, because the honeybees obtain the sweet material and then they concentrate and then store it and then secrete it again. So that's the reason why we can consider it as a glandular secretion. Beeswax, and then snake and other poisonous venoms from where Antisera is obtained, and toxins, etc. We use them in Ayurveda. So that's the reason why they are also to be considered. So these are all glandular products. The next one is, after animal, we have microbial sources like various antibiotics and some of the materials that are obtained from microbial source are also used as antibiotics and other materials are also obtained from microbial sources. And we have a recent addition of another source, that is what we call it as marine source. So from marine source, from marine algae, we know that agar is obtained from marine algae. Along with this, there are several reports that bioactive molecules are obtained from sea corals, sponges, fishes, marine microorganisms. In fact, cephalosporins are obtained from a microbe obtained from marine environment only. Okay, so marine invertebrates like ectinacidin, etc., anti-cancer molecules were also identified from marine resource. So friends, these are the different types of sources that we have as far as crude drugs are concerned. So in case of mineral source, we all are aware of certain things like kaolin, diatomite, bentonite, etc., which have a wide application in pharmaceutical product and cosmetic products. We knew this one, okay, talcum powder, and also kaolin, aluminium silicate. So we use them in various products, including cosmetics. Okay, so now, selection of a crude drug, how do you do that? It's a big challenge. It all depends upon the type of crude drug that you are going to use. On what basis you choose an apple in the market, that should tell you various techniques that we need to employ while obtaining a crude drug. Because crude drug is not like an edible. Okay, so it need to possess bioactive substance. It need to be free from adulterants. It must not be spoiled. Very less spoilage, contamination. Okay, so with crude drug, these are the problems. Okay, so it must be free from adulterants. Let's say if you are collecting leaves of senna, let's say if some other leaves were mixed, then that itself is a big issue for us. And when a crude drug is stored for some more time, if a storage facility is not good, then there is a possibility of spoilage, contamination. Because while storing, if 2-3 drugs are stored together, volatile oils of one of the drug may enter into other products. So thereby there is a possibility that others may catch the smell or chemical constituents of other herbs. So many reasons will be there. And bioactive substance is very, very important, because when a plant material is growing its biochemistry or biosynthesis is dependent on soil, environment, nutrients, stress factors, genetic material or mutations if they are there, and then time of collection, season of collection. Okay, so if a plant, if you are trying to collect it for for doing any kind of a plant material is used for, is collected for making a drug material, we all knew that a plant takes some time to grow, mature, and then it will synthesize the secondary metabolites. There are a few drugs are there, like if you take for example Taxus species, it takes 8 years for maturing, it will take another 14 years for complete biosynthesis of taxols in its bark and its needles. So thereby in total 20 to 23 years is needed for obtaining taxol sufficiently from the plant products. Okay, but in some cases we don't need to wait for this much long. Second thing is, some of the volatiles like lemongrass oil is collected in night time. If you collect it in the morning time, by the time you transport the material to the factory from where the lemongrass oil is actually extracted, you are going to unnecessarily expose the material to sunlight. So there is a possibility of degradation. Okay, and in some cases, some of the materials that will be there, the plant material, like cardiac glycosides, if you dry it above 40 to 45 degrees centigrade, expose it to a temperature up to this level, then cardiac glycosides will be denatured. You will see plant material looks like the same thing. You will not find any kind of a difference in the texture of a leaf, etc., but its chemical constituents are gone. So these are all the problems that and the things to be considered while selecting a crude drug. So that is the reason why there is an elaborate procedure evolved for selection of crude drugs. So here I am going to mention a few methods that we have for selection of a crude drug. Like, the first one is authentication or certified product. How do you select a crude drug? We can collect the material from an authenticated supplier where they have their own analytical lab, so that after doing analysis they will certify the authenticity of the sample and then they can send us. Because when you are running a factory, you need to have dependable suppliers who have preliminary analytical facilities. So they will actually collect the material, they will authenticate according to the guidelines, and then they will certify, so that they can be directly taken into consideration for your drug preparations. The second possibility is, let's say when you were provided with a material, either the powder form means unorganized. In case of unorganized drugs, powders, mixtures, etc., then there are some of the physicochemical properties are there, characteristics are there, which we are going to take into consideration. So we will select the crude drug based on the physicochemical characteristics, like extractive value. We have different procedures are there, like oil extractables, water extractables, etc., and drying, loss on drying, or LOD, loss on drying, And then we have some other properties like which are physical chemical properties like UV visible spectrophotometry, etc. So like that we can make use of those techniques to authenticate or select a crude drug. Like when milk is given, lactometer is used to find out whether how much quantity of water is there. So it is like that. Physical chemical properties are taken into consideration. The third and very useful and routinely used methodology is organoleptic characteristics. So how do you estimate authenticity of curry leaves? This is what we do regularly, okay? Curry leaves or anything like that, which when we go to market, we first smell, we see the color, we see the taste. So these organoleptic characteristics are also used for selection of a crude drug. The next one is chemical tests, which is one of the widely used and robust methodology. Because whenever we use a plant material, a plant material will show biological activity, bioactivity based on secondary metabolites. Secondary metabolites, okay? So if you take in simple, pepper seeds show biological activity because it has piperine. Okay, so if you take pepper seeds and extract it, seeds will remain the same, seeds will be there minus piperine. Okay, when you get this material, seeds without piperine, you hardly can differentiate original pepper and original pepper seeds and seeds without piperine. You can hardly recognize any change because the color, everything looks almost the same. But now if you test for piperine, then the chemical test will help you select the crude drug to identify whether the crude drug is of good quality or bad quality, so that you can choose select a crude drug based on the chemical test. This is one of the simple example that I can give you. There are so many such drugs are there where the chemicals are extracted, and whatever material that is available, whatever mark that is available in full organ form, like in case of seed, complete seed will be there, but you cannot differentiate the seed, quality seed, from extracted, exhausted seed. So that is the way. Okay, so friends, these are the four methods that we have regularly used for identification of crude drugs, whether unorganized or organized form. And the last one is microscopic evaluation. In case of microscopic evaluation, so when do we use microscopic evaluation? Especially for plant products. Okay, microscopic evaluation is given. Here we can do qualitative, second one is quantitative. In case of qualitative, we look for diagnostic features like calcium oxalate crystals, type of stomata, type of trichome, xylem or phloem fibers, etc. The type and the characteristic features are studied so that when the drug meets with the diagnostic features, then you can say that a crude drug can be selected. Otherwise, no. Okay? But when the drug is provided, then we can also see quantitative, like stomatal index, etc. Okay, so these kind of tests are also done to authenticate the material. So thereby, selection of a crude drug can be made by using microscopic evaluation. So while we are asked to do all these types of criteria, why are we using for selection of a crude drug? All these materials are used, all these procedures are used because crude drugs are obtained from nature. So when you are obtaining something from nature, the quality doesn't depend upon, the quality is not always in your hands. It all depends upon the natural conditions. So when you are looking for a particular crude drug with specified biological activity, you need to ensure that it confides, it agrees with the physicochemical characteristic, organoleptic characteristics, chemical tests, and microscopic evaluation. So thereby, we ensure that we are obtaining high quality crude drug material. When you start producing a drug with high quality material, then only you will be able to get drugs with high quality output. Okay, so sometimes if you are using, let's say, exhausted material is what you are using, bulk will be there, but there is no bioactive secondary metabolite, then in that case what will happen? Your drug does not show any biological activity. It's one of the biggest problems with the natural product drugs. So because of this reason, we do have several methods evolved over a period of time for authentication of a crude drug. Authentication. Now we have seen is the methods that we are using for selection of a drug, selection of a crude drug. Now we need to know what are all the various methods that we have for authentication of a crude drug. Let's say if you go to the market and if you choose an apple, how can you authenticate that this is the apple you are looking for? You may look for size, shape, color, flavor, taste, age, ripen state. So these are all the characteristics that we use for authentication of the type of apple that we have in the market, whether it is obtained from Shimla or it is obtained from Araku or something like that. Okay, so these are some of the characteristics that we ascribe to a natural product in order to authenticate its features, okay, its identity. So for a crude drug obtained from standard resource, where we got the certificate, etc., everything is there, or we got it through reliable resources, because in most of the cases, let's say you wanted to collect the crude drug from forest, we have to depend on the local tribal people for the collection of a crude drug. Though they ensure the identity of the material, but we have to study it by using pharmacognostic identification methods. What are all the pharmacognostic study methods? So here, from where you are collecting, place, soil, environment, conditions is what we have to study. The second one is microscopy. TS and LS of the material is studied, and then chemical tests are also conducted as per the protocol provided by in the pharmacopoeia, appropriate pharmacopoeia. The second one is botanical taxonomy. So in this case, the condition is somebody has provided you the plant material, but it was not authenticated. So there are ifs and buts. Then what to do? You cannot directly go into the pharmacognostical identification because its name is not identified. So you have to authenticate it first. How can you do that? You will do it by using a botanist. You take the help of a botanist so that they will do, you will be submitting the herbarium sample is prepared and submitted. so that the genus species is identified by using technical knowledge in botanical taxonomy. Okay, the next one is chemical identity and chemical tests. So we use or we heavily depend on the chemical tests for identification of a crude drug, especially when the material supplied is unorganized. Okay, unorganized. In case of unorganized crude drugs, means powders, extracts, mixtures, etc., chemical identification tests are extensively used. Let's say if somebody provided you the extract of cinchona, then you will be doing alkaloidal tests and also tests for identifying quinoline. Okay, quinine identification, fluorescent reaction will come with the chemical reagents. So identification tests are there that we are going to use especially over here for identification of the crude. The fourth one is again for unorganized drugs only, but here what we are going to use is the analytical data such as ash values, solubility criteria, extractive values, acid value, saponification value, etc. Especially for plant material, let's say when a plant material is provided to you, we'll be doing ash value so that how much quantity of inorganic material is remaining, and from ash value we'll be doing acid soluble, water soluble, acid soluble, all these things we are going to consider over here. And solubility, so let's say when you are asking for aqueous extract of so and so material, then that extract must go into water. So when you dissolve the material, it should not contain any insoluble material. Okay, because when an extract is provided to you, we don't know what is mixed inside that. Okay, that is the problem. Extractive value, especially in case of plant material, when they provided you the plant material, it shall contain secondary metabolites and other chemical constituents. So extractive value, like organic solvent extraction value, like hexane or ethyl acetate, butanol, n-butanol, water, etc., aqueous alcohol. Okay, like this we will obtain the extractive value with appropriate solvent. So when a drug is provided to you based upon the chemical constituents that are declared already, because we are not doing any R&D here, we are only taking the standard crude drugs and we are trying to make a formulation. Okay, drug material is prepared, so that's the reason why its extractive values are already defined. So if the extractive values are appropriately coming, then only we are going to consider that as an authenticated crude drug. Otherwise, the material that is supplied to you is an exhausted material. Let's say in case of pepper seeds, it contains a lot of oil soluble material. So when it is exhausted, the hexane soluble or ether soluble value, extractive value especially for hexane, will go down. Then what will happen, we will consider that the pepper material that is supplied to you is totally exhausted. You know this one. Okay, acid value and saponification value are used for fixed oils. Okay, the next one is identification of adulterants and substituents is another very very important aspect, especially for authentication of crude drug. Especially for crude drugs, we always will find substituents and adulterants. Sometimes adulteration or substitution happens by accident, because we don't know, because who is collecting the plant material for you? The people who are collecting plant material for you are not botanists or scientists. They are local people we are going to engage. So they cannot sometimes differentiate quality material from non-quality material, or authenticated material from other materials that are available in locally. Sometimes when you order a crude mal crude material from different part of the country, parts of the country. So regionally there will be a problem with the names, problem with the names and identity, names and identity. So vernacular names are used locally, because especially for crude drugs, when you are trying to collect material in the form of plant or extract, etc., these problems will come with the names and identity. Hence there is a possibility that original drug or authenticated drug may be mixed with other plant materials which you need to remove. Okay, so in the authentication, identification of adulterants and substituents is again another big task. The next one is determination of active constituents or chemical composition. Determination of active constituents and chemical composition is usually done by using spectroscopy techniques like UV, IR, NMR, etc. Okay, fingerprinting is done. And the second one is chromatography techniques like HPLC, HPTLC. So these are the two techniques which are extensively used right now for determination of active constituents and chemical composition. Okay, so usually you can see HPTLC fingerprinting is done. If you see the Ayurvedic pharmacopoeias, now it is mandatory that every drug or the extract, standardized extracts, are supposed to be tested with the HPTLC. A method is to be developed so that the active constituents are seen like a chromatogram, and then this is recorded. Now when we are collecting the same plant material or the crude drug, then we simply run another HPTLC and compare standard and test, so it must exactly come the same way as the standard. If one or two spots are missing, then that indicates that one of the herbal material that are used in the mixture, or the herb that is provided by the supplier, is not of good quality. Maybe the crude drug is collected in a different region, different days, or maybe it is spoiled, and so many other things will be there. So this is the way how we can authenticate a crude drug, by looking at the active constituents and the chemical composition. Next one is quality and purity of the herb. Okay, so here quality regarding, let's say if you go to the market, and then when you compare 2-3 apples, okay, so there you will be able to easily recognize the apple with the good quality. Okay, so the material must be free from spoilage, perfectly aged, perfect color or constitution. Okay, so this is what we need to see, especially the characteristics of the crude drug. And then purity means it is free from all other waste materials. Like let's say if you take a leaf, it is the leaf material which is biologically active, but if it contains the stack also, then what to do? It has to be removed. Okay, so this is one very important characteristic that we need to understand, because this will add to the weight of material, and also very low in bioactive constituents. So that's the reason why when we are asking for leaf, we must get only leaf, now no other things. When we are asking for leaf with good quality is to be obtained. Means if some of the leaf is spoiled, okay, maybe because of temperature, maybe because of storage or something like that, so all these things ought to be avoided. Okay, so friends, this is the way how authentication of crude drug is done by using pharmacognostical identification, botanical taxonomical tests, chemical identity and chemical tests, analytical data like ash value, solubility, extractive value, etc., And then identification of adulterants and substituents, chemical composition and biologically active constituents, quality and purity of the hair. So these are the aspects that one need to ensure while authentication of the crude drug. Okay. So friends, with this, hope you understood the concepts here.